important. That's how our leader trained us. It doesn't matter. I can be trying to push program and go to the bottom. I cannot allow them to continue, and I have to come in with this very short broadcast. Right? Okay. They cry. I am still on that very cry. They don't know that Nigerian government cried yesterday. They cried. They said, we cannot decide on the Mazen Nnamdi Kanu's case openly. That's what they mean, because they have been deciding on it, both in open and secret. Then they now want to go in secret. They say he should go to court. The idiot wearing mask say that Mazen Nnamdi Kanu can defend himself in the court. That is in their system. Did you understand? I have preached this in the morning, but this is the same issue, right? But there are things we want to pick out there. Okay? You have to go to the court. Then, what are his offenses, as they mentioned, as the idiot mentioned from his mouth? Do you know what they said? That he was abroad in Europe. Right? He was in Europe, then abusing this government, abusing. Then, have you charged him for the abuse? Then, what are the abuse? He said Buhari is dead. Right? He said that Fulani is taking over people's land. Okay? And he said that all the institutions are headed by Fulani, and all the arms of government are being headed by Fulani. Is that insult? Is that abuse? The abuse is that Buhari is dead. And you have every opportunity to prove it. Can any court prove that? No court can prove it. You are alive to prove it. Now that Mazen Nnamdi Kanu is here. But Mazen Nnamdi Kanu will present his forensic evidences in court, and court will prove it. But you, if you think you are alive, then go to the court or meet Ababaka Amalami to prepare this very charge that Mazen Nnamdi Kanu said that Buhari is dead. Simple. Stop jumping up and down trying to defend yourself as if you are alive. No. The whole world knows that Buhari is dead. This is a laughing matter. Now, they are not telling you that he's insulting, he's abusing the government, right? And I'm asking them, which court are you taking Mazen Nnamdi Kanu to? Is it the court that gave order to the DSS and they disobey? Is it the court that are loyal to DSS that they are taking Mazen Nnamdi Kanu to? Did you see how they are foolish? Now, what are they doing? They are crying out to the world that they don't know how to do this thing now. Even their court, they know their court doesn't work. What are they reporting now? They are telling the whole world that Mazen Nnamdi Kanu refused to compromise. They are telling the whole world that Mazen Nnamdi Kanu believes in his freedom. They are now telling the whole world that Mazen Nnamdi Kanu determined to die for Biafra to come. They are now telling the whole world that Mazen Nnamdi Kanu laid a very strong foundation of IPOB. That the structure is very strong. Then what are they saying? That political solution will not work. Who are they responding to with the political solution they put? Southeast governors, Southeast senators, Southeast politicians, Ike Ekweremadu. When we were agitating for free Nnamdi Kanu, when he was initially arrested, when we started agitating fresh earlier, do you know what Ike Ekweremadu was saying? We will look for a political solution. And all of them, if you ask them, they will say, we will look for political solution. Understand the language. They did not say political solution. We must force political solution. They said, we will look for political solution. Not IPOB said, though. Did you understand? Do you know that these people, these charlatans, that IPOB did not give them chance? Do you know the people IPOB gave chance? They gave the traditional rulers and the religious leaders chance. Did you understand? Understand me. Just follow me up. I want to clear some issues now. Chineke Gozirani, Nnamdi Kanu, Zirani Ofuma. Right? That's why we are called IPOB. Okay? Then, I am coming. Ike Ekweremadu was requesting for political solution. saying that a seat at home is a disturbing economy. Then many of them say that it should be political solution. They did not mention referendum. Now, when we allow the traditional rulers, we did not allow Ike Kuremado. He did not come. He went for a call for a communique. He read out a communique that they discussed with the senators, right? That is not meeting. And we did not give him job. We did not allow anybody. We did not give all of them privilege. We only gave privilege to the traditional rulers and the religious leaders. These are the people IPOB gave privilege to go for the release of our leader. Going for the release of our leader did not stop all our legal proceedings, both international and local. Right? Then, what we kept in order to maintain what they agreed with our leader, we just kept some civil disobedience. Right? Let us see what they can do. Do you know from then till now that the traditional rulers and the clergymen have failed? Do you see now, it is now the people that are supposed to go that journey that they did not consult are now coming out. Who are those people? Reverend Father A.G.K. Mbaka and the Ebube Monso. These clergymen, these religious leaders refused to consult, they refused to bring them in. They knew that they are the people that can request for the release of Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. And you know that these people, they cannot hide the truth. Did you understand? You may misinform them. You may misinform them. If you misinform them, and if they later find out the truth, they will now turn against you. That's how Mbaka works. You may misinform him, and he will work on it. And if he later find out his truth, he will now give a message and counter it and destroy it. He cannot pretend. He cannot keep defending it. That's how Mbaka works. Now, do you know that the clergymen did not consult, call Mbaka? Do you know? You know, they pick bishops. They did not, I know he's not a bishop. They did not consult Ebube Monso. Are you aware? Do you know they are coming out? Do you know many are coming out? Do you know there are pastors that are good people? They refuse to appoint the leaders of PFN, Pentecostal Fellowship Mission in states, right? Do you know that all the bishops are corrupt? Do you know that every bishop that they appointed, okay, do you know this man in Nsukka, Father Honor, that said that IPOB is a terrorist? Do you know he's among those going to Abuja? Are you aware? Do you know that Father Honor that said that IPOB is a terrorist organization, is a terrorist group, right? Yeah, IPOB is terrorist. Father Honor from Nsukka Diocese. Do you know that Bishop Chukwuma, that is against Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, who said that he thought that Mazi Nnamdi Kanu is smart, that they caught him with a woman? Do you know Bishop Chukwuma was among those that was meeting the impostor? You know, when IPOB allow you to die, if you are raising your hand up, you want to die, IPOB will give you a chance and they will block their defense. You cannot cross the defense. That is the highest thing IPOB will do. But will allow you to go. I can score a goal. IPOB can give you a chance to go for strike. They know you cannot, they cannot allow you on the defense. The last thing IPOB will do to bring a stranger in the defense. But if you say you can score, then we can put you in the match. Now, these people say they can score. We now allow them to go for striking. Do you know they have failed? Do you know they did not bring, they only appointed the enemies of IPOB and then Mazi Nnamdi Kanu? I am mentioning them now. Bishop Chukwuma was among them. Bishop Honor of Nsukka Diocese was among them. Bishop Chukwuma is Enugu Anglican Diocese. He's among them. He's against Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. There is a way IPOB works. When we are dealing with you, the time we will call you by your name will come and we will call you by your name. But you don't know, we will remember those things. Did you understand? Now, do you know that we did not ask for political solution? Do you know, when we called them, when we allowed them, we agreed with them that they can confront the federal government and request for the release of our leader, that our leader should be handed over to them. Did you understand? Now they come as elders and the religious leaders. The senators cannot come to us. The Ohanaeze cannot come to us. The governors cannot come to IPOB because they have failed. Did you understand? They are the people inviting army. We now, IPOB leadership, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, now allowed the traditional rulers and the clergymen, which he have never allowed before and given grace before. He now gave them grace. They have tried their best. Do you know what they now return to? Do you know what they have done? The plan was to destabilize IPOB when they approached first. Fulani told them their agenda. Now they now move back to destabilize IPOB because their political solution they are presenting, IPOB two demands have countered all their political solution. Do you know the key? When they say they will go, IPOB gave them the condition, these two conditions. And these two conditions, there is no agreement they can make that will counter these two conditions. Did you see where the problem is now? What are the two conditions? Free Mazi Nnamdi Kanu unconditionally. And give us this for Biafra referendum. These are the things we presented to them. These are the things we gave to the traditional rulers. Their political solution cannot come against this. And they have tried, or they have agreed, all that they have told Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. He is still pointing at the demand of the people, which is freedom of Mazi Nnamdi Kanu unconditionally and the Biafra referendum. And you know that these elders and the traditional rulers, these traditional rulers and the clergymen now returned to the president last now and told them that what IPOB insists on is free Mazi Nnamdi Kanu unconditionally, that they do not accept any political solution. They did not accept divide and rule. Right? Now, they did not accept any position in government. We did not accept 2023. We did not accept 5 states. We did not accept controlling of some resources. We did not accept those things. That what we demanded is free Mazi Nnamdi Kanu unconditionally and date for Biafra referendum. Now, the federal government is now replying to them that they cannot obey free Mazi Nnamdi Kanu unconditionally, which is automatically just like Biafra referendum. Did you understand? They cannot do it. Now, have we not done our best? Are we not true to do whatever we want to do without listening to anybody again as an elder? Did you see it now? Now, let me tell you. The autopilot has now, this is the reason why I come. Now I'm telling you, maybe you don't understand what we are doing. Political solution have failed. And some ignorant people. Now that political solution, have IPOB moved for any political solution? Their side is no. IPOB have been demanding for free Mazi Nnamdi Kanu unconditionally and dead for Biafra referendum. Biafra referendum is a political solution. But IPOB did not mention the word political solution. Did you understand? Do you know that this protest we do is political solution? Are you not aware? Is it not civil disobedience? Okay, now, if you protest now, is it not part of the government? Is it not part of politics to show your anger? Right? Okay, now, referendum, people to decide where they belong to, is it not political solution? Is it not how they do their voting? To vote for president or senate, president or senate or governor, all their political posts, is it not by voting? Now, IPOB demands for referendum. We did not mention the word political solution. It was Southeast politician that initiated the language that political solution is the best, that IPOB should stop sit at home and let them go for political solution for the release of Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. He is their son. He is this. Right? Now, the autopiloters that they always say, where is the political solution? Are you asking IPOB or you are asking Southeast traditional rulers and religious leaders, or you are asking self-made governors or senators. Did IPOB mention political solution? IPOB have two demands: free Mazinam Dekan unconditionally and date for Biafra referendum. Do you know that Biafra referendum is political solution? That is IPOB's own political solution, which cannot be changed. Which is the offense of Mazen Namdekano? That is the offense of Mazen Namdekano. Why must he demand for referendum? That is the offense. And why must he launch a security outfit that will prevent the terrorists from occupying our land and taking over our land? Is that not his major two offenses? And why did he expose the death of Buhari? Three major offenses, which they have not even mentioned on the charges against him. These three major offenses, which is not an offense, that's why they did not mention these things. Fulanis, we stop you from invading our land, we secrete, and we demand for the freedom to decide if we will continue to be killed. If we accept to be killed by Fulani, then we vote against Biafra, right? And what else? We said we don't need anything politics. How do they use the word political solution when we have never called up any candidate? They gave IPOB allegation that we have a candidate in Anambra. Did we discuss anything with Anambra aspirants? No. We only discussed with traditional rulers and the religious leaders. They said they will go. We gave them condition, and they have gone with our condition. They went to try. They have presented our condition. They came back with the federal government condition. And IPOB leadership and IPOB as a whole rejected the federal government's solution, political solution, which they accepted, the only one they allowed. We now reply back to the leader, those people, as they gave us reply. We told them that we insist on free Mazen Namdekano unconditionally and date for Biafra referendum. And they now returned back and they replied them. Now they are now crying that after all said and done, that IPOB insist on these two things. Is that not what they mean by telling you that they have nothing to do about a political solution? Because our demand is against their political solution, and we have never shifted. Then why is autopilot us, instead of thanking IPOB leadership and IPOB as a whole for defeating Nigeria, and thanking Mazen Namdekano for defeating them, for not obeying them, for insisting on Biafra referendum and his freedom unconditionally? He have never asked the barrister to file a motion for bail. We never file motion for bail, because filing motion for bail is unconditional release. But we never file motion for bail. We insisted on his unconditional release, and we have no intention of filing motion for bail. Why are you now saying that political solution have failed? Is it our business? Do we ask for political solution? Our political solution is Biafra referendum. We never mentioned the word political solution. Did you understand now? So the autopiloters, they have no base. They are just moving through and flow. According to the book of Job, God asks Satan, where are you from? He say, through and flow, looking for whom I would devour. That is how they do. When we make achievement, instead of them to honor Mazen Namdekano, they will now be fighting against him. Did you see how they do? Now the federal government have honored Mazen Namdekano by saying that he must change from and they start supporting Nigeria. That is to say, they are telling you that this man is strong. He insists on Biafra. Why not you honor him? Why not you thank his God? All you now do is to come against IPOB and say, here is the political solution. Are you foolish? Are you stupid? Are you mad? That IPOB is winning. Federal government is telling you that IPOB is winning. That IPOB refused to obey them. That they have tried all they have as their system, that IPOB insisted, that they have used the traditional rulers and the clergymen to convince IPOB, that IPOB insisted, that they have used them to convince Mazen Namdekano, that Mazen Namdekano insisted. Is that not what they meant? Is that not the language? Is that not their language? Facebook is pinning it there. Facebook pinned it in a place. They cannot allow your comment. We know you are commenting now, but we proceed. That is what I am here to say. Why do they call political solution? Political solution has failed. We told you political. Are you stupid? IPOB said they need Biafra referendum. How do we mention political solution? The politicians that mention political solution, are they not the people you will go to and say, where is your political solution? You will start campaigning. So we are free to do how we are supposed to do it. This is our time to do the way of IPOB because nobody will be allowed. Nobody will be listening to because we have tested them all. You know, they thought it will end there. You know, Fulani promised them to jail Mazen Nnamdi Kanu. Fulani promised them everything. But the fire is still increasing. The fire is burning. And we have not even poured fuel. It is only the firewood is just burning. When we pour it fuel now, do you know that these traditional rulers and the religious leaders have no place to be, to stay? Are you aware? Are you aware that Father Ona, Bishop Ona of Nkosuka Diocese, is an enemy of IPOB? Do you know he was the people that took the slot? Do you know that all the bishops that presented themselves are the people that took slot from federal government? Are you aware? We allow them now. I told you we brought them out so that there will be no more voice. Go to my old brokers. I say there will be no more voice to counter IPOB. No more voice. You know why? We have defeated the traditional, the Ohanaeze. Ohanaeze has no more voice. They always dance on our tune. They have no voice because they are criminals and liars. And this Facebook work very, very well, right? Continue to attack the program. Don't allow me to see comments. Continue. Now, the senators have conspired and with Ohanaeze and the governors, even Quen Rogers was there. Rogers was chairman, Southeast governors. Are you aware? Under IPC, before you get to my. Do you know that they all conspired and invited Python dance? Are you aware? And launched Python dance and sponsored it with their money. Are you aware? Money from our land, though. They sponsored the killings of our people. Now, do you know that the traditional rulers collected money to sell our communities, our forests, our bushes? Do you have to Fulani? Now, they see that the governors have no honor, that they chanted for political solution, Turike, Kurimada and Co., and we did not listen to them. These criminals now went through the traditional rulers and clergymen. That's why they invited them in the meeting in Enugu. That's why Malami said that they will go back to the old way. The main arm of government, connecting, bringing back the traditional rulers and the local government into the leadership so that they will work for vigilante, right? Then, all is against IPOB. Now, through there, they could be able to see the saboteurs in the bishops to call them and tell them their mission. And they are now confronted themselves. And today, who are they? They have disgraced themselves. Though they are still on the mission for release Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, but they went to try. They went to try because they went for their own brain. But the Fulani agreed with them. But the demand of IPOB is greater than their own discussion. And they have confronted IPOB with their own solution. Not that they do not meet up, agree on a solution. They agreed. But their solution is against the demand of IPOB. Did you see the problem? Our demand is free Mazen Nnamdi Kanu unconditionally. And they give us date for Biafra referendum. That is our own demand. Anybody telling you that leadership went for a political solution, that person is an idiot and a criminal and a thief and a saboteur. It was the politician that we are chanting for political solution. So stop, let us go for political solution. When IPOB gave press release, they never mentioned political solution. They said that the traditional rulers and the clergy, religious leaders said that they are going to free, they will allow them to go for free Mazen Nnamdi Kanu. Then we are giving them privilege to go for that. Okay? But our demand is free Mazen Nnamdi Kanu unconditionally and therefore Biafra referendum. Whenever they bring report of their meeting or negotiation back to IPOB leadership. IPOB always come after their brokers. They will still tell you that we still believe, we still insist on the freedom of Mazinam Dikano unconditionally and date for Biafra referendum. Is that not what they always say? Both Chike Dozim, have they deviated? This is our own political solution, referendum. But the word political solution never come out from the mouth of us. It came out from the mouth of politicians. But we did not allow them. We only allowed traditional rulers and religious leaders. Did you see how autopiloters are being deceived? Hey, where is their political solution? Who told you about political solution? Are we Ike Kurimadu? Have our demand been destroyed? No. Our demand is free Mazinam Kano unconditionally and date for Biafra referendum. Have we not succeeded to take over our land? Have we not succeeded? Can anybody draw us back now? Everybody will now dance the tune of our beat, right? This music, they will now dance. There will be no voice to counter us. I say it. Ohanaeze's voice have died. Governor's voice have died. Senator's voice have died. Then the traditional rulers and the religious leaders' voice we allowed to come up have died also. Then who will now beg us? Now, is it not your time to thank IPOB leadership? Did you know you everything you do now, you'd have been under blame? Hey, we ask them to give us chance. They refuse. This IPOB, they don't listen. They don't listen to others. This is what you would have been hearing. This is what you would have been hearing now. All this our demand to stop national anthem. Did you not see what they are saying? Now, what are you going to confront them with? You will shut them up by, where is Mazinam Dekan? Have we not given you a chance? Did you see the language? When IPOB is dealing with you, you need to be careful, because the time will land on, the time you will know yourself, we have done with you. Before you know yourself, I am a challan. You need chance, we'll give you a chance. Hey, I can score now. We'll give you a chance, you go and play. We cannot allow you to the defense. You cannot come closer even to our midfield. You can't come. We can move you to the front. You try now, you see that it's not easy. You will see it's not easy. You will go back and sit down. You wait and watch. Watch the YPOB will play the ball. Just watch. Get out of the road. We don't want anybody to block us. We know that the traditional rulers would have been blocking us. You have nothing to confront them with, because you have not given them chance before. They will keep chanting. You would have been hearing their communique since, that their children are not listening, and the people will be against you. They would have been coming giving press release from press release to press release, that IPOB is stubborn, they didn't listen. We would have, if had we moved, we would have released Buhari, Nnamdi Kanu from Buhari. We told you to allow us, IPOB. You know, why did you not allow us? And the people will be blaming you. Have we not allowed them? Then why are you posing it? Why are you pointing IPOB as the key for political solution? Have IPOB stopped from fighting for free Mazinam Dikano? Are you not foolish? Have we changed from our demand? Is it not our demand that is pursuing them? Is it not our demand? Do you think that they don't reply to IPOB leadership, the outcome of their negotiation? They always reply to us, and everything has been kept secret. They always reply. But when they reply, IPOB will present the two demands to them, telling them to go back to the Fulani and tell them this is the demand. And they will now send their agent to Mazinam Dikano. And Mazinam Dikano will still reply them the same thing. That is the confusion there. Not that the traditional rulers did not come up with something, but it is not on our own favor. They are bringing both Igbo presidents. They are bringing some positions in government, right? Like a police and some things. There are things they want to touch. We are not on that level, because the mother of our leader cannot come back. We have crossed that level of appointing some people and telling them, hey, we have compensated you and start working something. No, that time we begged them to give us seaport. That time have passed. You know, that time for international airport have passed. We will now construct our own in the name of Biafra. Anything they build now will destroy this. All this, their airport, when Biafra come, will demolish it and build a better one. So if they are dreaming of building something for us, that is part of their negotiation. They are promising Igbo presidency. That is part of their negotiation. But it is against the demand of IPOB. And whenever they come to that very wall of the demand of IPOB, it always jam back. It works like bad to sender. When they send it, it will jam on the wall and go back to them. Because what IPOB said there, that their own negotiation or their political solution cannot cross, it cannot penetrate. What is this? What are those things? Free Mazandamu can unconditionally and date for Biafra the freedom. It is uncrossable. They have rallied around, they have brought solution, they have presented it to IPOB leadership, but it is not accepted. Because the demand of the people cannot be truncated. Did you understand where we are going now? Did you understand? So when they want to fool you, where are the political solutions? You tell them that IPOB is victorious, that our demand is Free Mazandamu Kanu and date for Biafra referendum, Free Mazandamu Kanu unconditionally, that their own political solution, that is Fulani political solution, which they have been giving to the traditional rulers, and the one that the traditional rulers have been presenting to them, is not matching to what we need. And anytime they bring the reply back to IPOB, IPOB always confront them with these two demands, and which they know that since then, we never change our language. And since then, Mazandamu Kanu have never changed his language. Mazandamu Kanu doesn't care. He's not in a haste. You must give him referendum. He's not in a haste. He's only a fool that will try to deceive you, telling you the date our leader is supposed to come out. No. But a freedom fighter who knows Mazandamu Kanu and who knows Fulani, how they do strong head. You know that I told you that I won't die today. Have jam, I won't die now. Fulani is I won't die today. But Mazandamu Kanu is I won't die now. And they have jammed. Just watch the match. Just give your support. Watch the match. Watch. Did you see what he's doing to them? Why do he give IPOB leadership these two demands before they came? We have started asking for Free Mazandamu Kanu unconditionally and date for Biafra referendum. Immediately, they started gathering to say that they want to go for his release. Now, we now give them what we need. And when they came, they know it was not new. Did you understand? And today, they have surrendered that our solution, our own demand, is against them. Then, we will now give you what we kept in our cupboard. Do you see how IPOB works? You know, we learn it very, very well. We know how our people works. Never compare us with any tribe that have gotten their independence. And never compare Biafra with any people at all on earth. Then we know how our people works. That's why our leader always allowed them to do what they believe. But IPOB is command and control. Now, when IPOB issues order, Biafra now understood that what IPOB is doing is right. The spirit of Biafra will now surrender them. They will obey. But the people that Mazandamu Kanu commands that are under oath is IPOB. And because of our good works, Biafrans are now being carried along. Because they love what we are doing. And they trusted IPOB that we can never fail. Did you understand? We move. Now, how do you come up and say political solution? I have failed as an autopilot. Who told you we ever agreed on political solution? We agreed on referendum and Free Mazandamu Kanu unconditionally. Every time we come on broadcast on Radio Biafra, that has been what we always say. And that has been the final, the conclusion of the matter. And this is always a strong wall that is not penetratable by the Fulani. All this gathering, all their meeting, all their conspiracy, all this discussion since our leader, we gave them chance to go. None have been accepted by IPOB leadership. Or do you think they don't give us reply? They have been giving IPOB reply. And IPOB never disclosed any of their meeting, all their meetings with them. Do you know they have confronted our leader? Our leader always replied them with what we need. Then how is it that the enemy paid agents instead of them to be appreciating Mazen Nnamdi Kanu for remaining resolute and defeating the enemy? Even to this time, they are not telling you that is their political solution. Are you foolish? Are you stupid? Are you mad? Fulani said that Mazen Nnamdi Kanu is abusing the government. That idiot that they put face mask is abusing the government. Is that not what they said? How do he abuse the government? And he is issuing order that is against the economy. So, what the idiot said there? Did you understand? Now, instructions or what that is against their national economy. Then we are asking them, are you judge now? If you are not judge, I think you have attorney general. Can't you give them the charges? Can't your attorney general prepare those charges? Then where are they taking the case to? Is there any court in Nigeria? I am asking, do Nigeria have court? If they have court, why is it that DSS disobeys court order? Then which other court are you taking the case to? And I am asking Nigeria, do you want if a judge give a ruling, a wrong ruling, right, to favor you against Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, that any human being will accept it? No, now DSS will first obey previous court rulings on the favor of Mazen Nnamdi Kanu. Or do you think we are fools? So you have failed totally. Then I want to tell the cabals, do you think you will run away, you will go free from the case of extraordinary rendition? You know, when you listen to the idiot putting on face mask, Yusuf Muhammad, which they call Buhari, he was talking, not allowing him. Who are you? Somebody from Niger, from Niger Republic. He has said you're not allowing a citizen. Are you mad? Somebody that is not a citizen of Nigeria. They have used your name and committed the case of extraordinary rendition. And you answer for the case. Extraordinary rendition is not a soft case. Forget your going around. Nigeria is completely gone. So, let me ask you. So, you think if the Buhari is alive, this thing that this idiot said, is it what the Buhari will say? Are you telling me, just reason back, that Buhari will just say that he has no power, that there is nothing he can do? Is that what Buhari will say? Buhari will even tell you what Mazen Nnamdi Kanu did to him. When he was alive, he said that what this boy have done to this country, I will never allow him to go. Is that not what he said? Did he say court? Buhari do not even talk, he can't talk about court. Did this man speak like Buhari? Buhari always speak, as far as it's an Igbo issue, he must issue another extra statement. He must add it sentiment. He must add it provocative words. That's how he talks. He said that the idiot is Buhari. Nonsense. I was listening to, you know, this Nigerian media, that's why we call them foolish people. I don't care who you are. Are you not foolish? Why did you not ask the Buhari? But Mazen Nnamdi Kanu said that the president of Nigeria, which is the current president, Buhari, is dead. Can't you add it on his charge? Is that not what media personnel are supposed to ask? They are there going around and talking rubbish with an idiot. Why are you? You claim to be a media personnel. I am a media punch. I am a Sahara reporter. You are with a man, a president, that somebody campaigned for how many, from 2017, till how many years that he is dead. Because of it, the house was invaded. Now the man is here in the custody. And the man is why you are interviewing the idiot on face mask, Muhammad Yusuf from Niger Republic, alias Buhari. Then, why did you not present this very issue to him, Mr. President. But Mazen Kanu said that you are dead, and you have carried this campaign for years. So what do you have to do about this? Because the man in question is in your country. So is it not better you confront him to prove what he said, or he is still in detention now? Why not add it on the charge? Give him a charge. I think the Attorney General is supposed to add it on the charges against him, because he's now in Nigeria, and I believe that is a strong allegation against the president. Is that not what part of what the media personnel are supposed to ask the idiot? Did they present this issue? Then what made them a media man? The main issue, a serious insult, the serious abuse to a living president and to a living to Senate House and to the House of Rep members and the Nigerians as a whole, that somebody campaigned that the president is dead for over 4 years. And you are now holding the man in your custody. And the media personnel interviewed an imposter claiming to be the man. Now, claiming to be Buhari. Now, is it not an opportunity to present this question to him? But Mr. President, the same man, Mazen Kanu, said that you are dead and that he have forensic evidences. Is it not better now that we settle the issue at once by confronting him or with the charges, or confronting him live for him to prove it, to prove his claims? Is that not how people reason? Is that not how media works? Is it very hard? Is this a threat to president? It's not a threat. It is a very direct work of the media. Then do you want me to come and ask them? You that is president there, can't you bring this issue? These are the people killing Nigerians. Then Nigerians that are here, listening, you are looking for a fault to PNIPOB. I am asking you, are you not in a position to campaign that Buhari should confront Mazen Nnamdi Kanu with the charges of allegation of his death, or confront him by presenting him to the Senate House, or present him, or come to confront Mazen Nnamdi Kanu in DSS with witnesses from all the regions, right? So that Buhari will go, this year Buhari will go to DSS and challenge him, Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, and Mazen Nnamdi Kanu will challenge him and prove that he's dead. Is that not what Nigerians are supposed to be campaigning? And there are two things Mazen Nnamdi Kanu promised there, which is the only solution for Nigerian problem. He said, if after all we find out that Buhari is alive, then I will surrender Biafra. Then I will give my life for life jail. Then is these things not okay? If they later discover that Buhari is dead, do you know that Nigerians are free? Because the Cabal's foundation will fall and all of you will be freed and the Fulani will run away from killing you. These things must favor Nigerians. This thing, it must favor them. It's either Biafra is freed or IPOB stop Biafra agitation, right? Or Buhari prove that Buhari is dead, then the Cabal's will all vanish. And Biafra will come. And they do the welcome. And every tribe will be free. Is that not what you are supposed to be campaigning? You are looking for where to talk about Nnamdi Kanu case. This person betray him. But you cannot campaign that the presidency, not even a media aid, none of their media aid can be able to say that we are challenging Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, now he's in Nigeria, to repeat that his claim that Buhari is dead. Is that not how to fight this very battle and stop it once and for all? Criminals everywhere, Buhari that have died since. I keep challenging you. Facebook, I know you are listening now. You know I challenge them with my reasons. You know now, you can, tackling me is just evil. Tackling me is evil. I present my argument very clear. Now that this man is here in Nigeria, why not them prove him wrong that he's alive? Simple. So you don't need to attack my program. Very, very important. Where is dead? Don't need to try it. So IPOB never mentioned political solution. It is Nigeria politicians that are saying that a political solution is the best. Political solution is the best. Both Anambra governorship aspirants, they say political solution is the best until the IPOB allow traditional rulers and the religious leaders to go for the release of our leader as they said they can go. We did not allow them to the defense of IPOB. They only go for striking. And we passed the ball for them. Since then, they could not be able to score. Not that they have not been communicating with our defense, which is IPOB DOS. They have been communicating, and we have been giving them pass. The type of ball we play and the type of thing we need, right? We presented these two things to them, Free Mazinan Kan unconditionally, and date for Biafra referendum. We never changed. And all they have come up with cannot match with what we agreed. And there is no way than the federal government to speak through the mouth of an impostor, okay, alias Buhari, to say that this political solution cannot will not work. Because they are just telling you that their own political solution was not accepted by IPOB. That is the language. Understand what they are saying. They are not telling you that their own political solution was not accepted by IPOB. That IPOB keep confronting them with the Free Mazinam Canon conditionally and date for their free freedom. Is that not what they meant? And you, as an autopilot, you are not trying to tell us, where is the political, are you mad? Don't you know that referendum is political solution? But the very word political solution did not come out from the mouth of IPOB leadership. It came out from the mouth of politicians. Right? But when we allowed the traditional rulers and the clergymen, we told them that what we need is Free Mazinam Kan unconditionally and date for Biafra referendum. And they have rallied around. They could not be able to meet up with it. And our duty now is to apply that things we kept on in our stores. You know, they asked us to stop from some civil disobedience. That's what they discussed with our leader. Right? And we now stop it, and we kept pushing the... We kept pushing. Okay, thank you. Thank you. And we kept pushing our legal proceedings and we stopped the civil disobedience. Now, after they have replied IPOB at the end of the year and IPOB gave the message back, then when they replied IPOB, what did IPOB present to them this year? Civil disobedience again. But we seized all those things. Did you see? Did you see that they have finished their own tenor? Did you see we cannot give them chance again? Do you know that that very national anthem is civil disobedience? Are you aware? Are you aware that everything that is on our table now is all about what they ask us to wait, not to do, until they let them see, go and free, for Free Mazinam Kan. Now that they did not succeed, are we not applying those things? Do you know that many things are coming? Their government will be on hot seat, and the politicians will be on hot seat. They will not have a balance here. Do not come here to come instead of giving IPOB honor, instead of thanking Mazinam Kan for standing on the truth, instead of thanking IPOB DOS for standing on the demand of the people, for not compromising. Whenever they confront them with anything, any enticement, any bribe, they always confront them with Free Mazinam Kan unconditionally and date for Biafra referendum. Whenever Chike Dozim come for the broadcast, he will always remind them that we are asking for the release of Mazinam Kan unconditionally and date for Biafra referendum. Have they changed? Have they changed? They never changed. This is the matter I come to settle. Yes. Mary. Okwara Mary. Igbo. Mbokwere. Okay. Igbo Mbokwere. Damasin. Okay. All of you are watching us and we are proceeding this very morning. This is our second edition of today's broadcast. Second edition. Hey, him didn't need the data on my phone. Uncobble, he raised it up. He raised the air. He raised the air. He raised the air. We confront it. Each all can preach every after 12 hours. I'm ready. Each all 10 hours. I preach gum 10 hours. I preach gum 8. I preach gum 6 hours. Standing. I was standing. No. We are ever ready. So that is I in Indian Subu. I in a one day show wow. I in Indian Subu. I am a good day. A bubble and the ash, if you be Zurke, a bubble and the ash, we do cross them. A bubble and hash, full and is confused. Did you not see what the idiot claiming to the Buhari is saying? Did you not see? Did you not see them? So you think that the main Buhari will say this thing? Main Buhari that would have been boasting, who is now referring us to the court. Look at you. So Buhari that would have been boasting of how he is going to jail Mazen Nnamdi Kanu is now coming calm, speaking calmly. How can Buhari speak like that? Very calm, without boasting, without making mouth, without any provocative words. Rubbish. No man. You are telling us as if we are children. Who don't know Buhari? So Buhari will be alive. And Mazen Nnamdi Kanu will say Buhari is dead. And the Mazen Nnamdi Kanu will be brought to Nigeria. And the Buhari will ignore him without confronting him with that very language. Are you insane? Are you mad? Who told you the main Buhari will ignore that very insult? Who told you? Buhari? You say Buhari is dead. Buhari, and he's alive. You brought Nnamdi Kanu here. He now speaks like a baby on a broadcast. He now on live interview. You are insane. You are mad people. The Nigerians are useless. How can Buhari speak like that? When he know that the man is here, he don't know how he boasts. He would have been boasting yesterday how he's going to jail Nnamdi Kanu this year if he did not stop the rubbish. And how he's going to kill IPB. Is that not how Buhari is used to talk? Are you mad? The idiot is not Buhari. Buhari cannot be calm. When this man say he's dead, and this man have been brought here, and Buhari will be speaking very calm. You are insane. You don't know Buhari. You are a mad idiot. You are a stupid idiot. Facebook, remove them. Remove them. Continue. No, Lagos. No, Facebook. Can you defeat us? The answer is no. Can you challenge us? The answer is no. You can only try now. Autopilot that promised you to make it alpha, they fell. Mad people. You can't make it. As far as it's to defeat IPOB, you can't make it. You can make it in any politics. Right? Not in defeating IPOB. Because we are selfless warriors. We fight now without payment. So how do you defeat us? Right? Thank you. Unconditionally. How we IPOB they present every time. Every time Mohanya, the IPOB leadership reply in Habatra na meeting, negotiation committee, are you not aware that ne a president na Achoginya Nnamdi Kanu 5 state? Are you not aware na Achoginya Kaijira Kai Pop Tonya Gawo Igbo president? Are you not aware? Are you not aware? Awe imagine when some military army chief or police chief or Hindus as Nage Nyonyi Igbo. Imagine. But IPOB Juraju. We still insist leadership equally betray. This is the opportunity to chop money. Opportunity of DOS to chop money. Ubu and now. Because in your plan, how could you find now? But Nigeria government are trying. When you have use the IPOB, change the language, free Mazen Nnamdi Kanu unconditionally, and give us there for Biafra freedom. This very demand, they come from our leader Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, on your Ozugbo kuri IPOB present here before ndi Abiawaze senior her chance and we had their church chance in here IPOB present here in here IPOB kwakwara lawyers. This is the two language I ngwara lawyers. Did you understand? Oh, here kwa lawyers ijaga. That's why they cannot file motion for bail. Did you see where Facebook keep them? 23 ndano mpama. Who is listening to you? Complain, continue to report the program. I will continue to destroy everybody that is trying to penetrate or to crush our road. I will crush you. Emotation is one. I don't know. Do you know how we are equipped? Immediately you jump out. Look at the things we have defended. This is very natural things. I won't go ahead on a shop. Can you go ahead? Go ahead and walk with you. Go ahead and in a big walk with you. Shop, I won't go ahead and walk with you. Okay, to a real. All right. Of course, all right. I got no do me to a real. Go ahead on a you may travel what to a shop or what to a yard. You may land there what to a yard and go ahead and you know yard. But if what to a yard, I'll give you which. This is natural. This is the things I need to keep from no money. Oh, we handed it to an alaba. Ugu no na fee, when we hand on you. Ugu ni ne no no mugu lo, but mugu ni ne no no we hand on you. Anyway, after our generation, next generation, I got use you. Did you understand? Biafra, be again when I get when minister. Minister na hutane when minister of oil. Kane when minister of uncle, this uncle. Uncle. Bank ega mana, any of land on agriculture, Caronian azoa. By then, you see that our people have money, we put it in agri. If you put it now, Fulani will invade your farm. And if you want to invest your money, they will tell you that you cannot sell this here, you cannot sell this here. Dangote will be selling here. You cannot sell here. You will sell to at a so-so place. Did you understand? They will not give you boundary. Now, that is why we need our freedom. If you don't know. Makobododi ha ana eji mak ana eji chegbe amara mgbe wo ogoro jire egbe ana eji egbe ma na abai wolokochi ahun hale egbe opposite odu mmiri na eru ahun hale oge ahun oge okochi oge November this agwaye no abai wolokochi ihe awu obodo agozi ina kataga ibi asim na I should go business or do this or do agwaye na na ime business ana ebu ona. Right? Ma oge chọ onye ga kwụgwọ. Oge chọ onye lorita ọnọ chi ga na kwụgwọ. Do you think it's what we come here? Danu man. You are doing autopiloting. If you see a very good victory secured by IPOB, instead of in our ekele IPOB leadership for not betraying us, they always come up with these two demands. Free Mazinamkan unconditionally. Or day and the date for their family freedom. And the picture our leader may approve. Kite in a profile. Here no quadio, free Mazinamdi Kanu unconditionally. Mazinamdi Kanu prisoner of conscience. The same thing unconditionally, Anho. They never changed. They never collected money. Nothing. But the person, the people that are countering his order, what did they collect? They collect life. Okay, they love Mazinamdi Kanu. Now, why is federal government frustrated? Is it not because the orders of Mazinamdi Kanu are being obeyed? Do you know that this very picture we change as our profile picture is a very serious signal to the federal government that we obey his command? Do you know that they are seeing the picture now? It is a very mad condition. They are mad now. Federal government is mad. How do Facebook, how do social media turn to that very picture of Mazinamdi Kanu? They are very, very mad. Thank you. Welcome, Monday James. Have you seen it? Have you seen how we are defeating them? Instead of you to give honor to whom honor is due, Mazinamdi Kanu, who could be able to stand these idiots till today, and they are confessing that their political solution cannot work because IPOB demands is greater than their political solution. Free Mazinamdi Kanu unconditionally and death for Biafra referendum. There is no meeting you have. We told them, any meeting you have, remember that our demand is free Mazinamdi Kanu unconditionally and death for Biafra referendum. And all their meeting, they have replied IPOB leadership. We counter them, their demand with these two demands, and today they are shocked. They say Mazinamdi Kanu have never agreed. He is dancing on their tone. That's what they mean now, because he insisted on Biafra referendum. So, and he have never allowed the barrister to file a motion for bail. That's why they were torturing him to see if he can ask them for bail. But he insisted on the unconditional release, which is the key to Biafra referendum. Which is the key for Biafra freedom. And the more we ask for that, the more we are occupying our land with serious orders. And from there, we'll back it up with so many civil disobedience. There is a level we are hiding. Do Do you know that will frustrate the North this year? Do you know? Because Fulani will try to frustrate the Northerners in the name of trying to starve the East, without knowing that the East has been blessed already. Stopping Nama is a very big blow to the Fulani. Forget the agaragara. It will not bring food. Are you farmers? When did the cattle carriers now turn to farmers? Is it not been way that farm mad people? When did you turn to farmers, Fulani? When? You stop rearing cow. You are telling us you stop bringing your food. Are you stupid? What you have is cow. You are trying to wicked the Northerners. Because the Northerners, they are peaceful Northerners. Fulani is the problem. Even there are Northerners living in our place, there are Fulanis that do their legitimate businesses in Biafra land before. They don't engage on killings, right? And they are not Katoriaras. But now, this very Buhari Fulani, you know, the Buhari Fulani is different. They are foreigner, current foreign, though all of them are foreigner, but these ones now came with a mission, they came with a gun. Did you understand? The other Fulani came under missionary, under Riarenkau, no gun, no. Though they killed King Yunfa. But this one, these people will come with a gun and the government back up. And they are free to enter army or police. Anyone, we are free to enter. They now destroy the lovely, the condition, that is, the normal life of former other Fulanis that we are living peacefully because they committed this offense now. And those Fulanis are crying. So the same thing, they are trying to bring division in the North because the main, this place they call North Central, Middle Belt and Co., that are the farmers. They cannot allow their food to be wasted in the name of, because we say we don't need cow and a goat or Fulani. Did you understand? Did you see that they are trying to cause confusion in the North? So everything IPOB do is legit. We will destroy the North with this very implementation of stopping cow. Do you know why? Fulani will try to force other Northerners to join them on their useless protest to suffer the North, the East. Then the Northerners will divide more and more. Thank you. Thank you. We move. We continue. Did you understand the language now? That IPOB have destroyed them. We have destroyed them. We will keep coming up with more and more. We will keep coming up with more and more. We will keep coming up until we take over this land. Very soon, the whole North will turn against Fulani, the whole North. Very soon. We have our strategies. We'll be applying it one by one. By the time they will know it, they are gone. And that is where I will bring it to an end this very moment. Thank you for joining us. Thank you for listening. Thank you for sharing. Your duty is to share. Do not be stingy in sharing. I have been, thank you, Rita Brown. You are welcome, but I am rounding up. I have been here this morning, and I come back again. Okay? I came back again. So this very moment, I will be shutting it down. I came back to broadcast and counter some rubbish that came out from the enemies, and I will be going off now. Thank you. Thank you. We move. Kachineke gozunu nile. We will continue to propagate this very gospel in truth and in honesty. Ebobli ishina amen at the struggle. Esi zikwala. Continue. Nyobla ganaga positively. Okay? Thank you. I want to know if you are going to send the IPOB to destroy us. Have they succeeded? Federal government will not speak now. They would have been having hope. They would have been promising them of a political solution. But now, they have seen that their plan to destroy IPOB and free Mazen Nnamdi Kanu when IPOB have been destroyed. They have seen it that it is impossible to destroy IPOB. So they have now told you political solution will not work because their target is to destroy IPOB. Then they will now release IPOB leader. It's just like destroying your compound, killing your brothers, then releasing you from detention. Did you see you have no help? Anybody can call you to sleep in his or her house. and you can sleep in the house of the enemy. They can kill you at any time. So that's how they want to keep our leader. They want to bring him out without a building. They want to destroy his house before releasing him. That's why they are confessing. Their political solution cannot work because their political solution is to destroy IPOB and release him. Anji madana Allah. You are a useless idiot. Who is that Murphy? Aaron Abagi. Chineke kpọọ oku. You see, tell people not to follow DOS. We should follow your mother. Anum Pama. Look at your picture. Any of the admin should do the needful to this idiot. Look at his say he's Murphy. Onye Obodo. Just imagine the stupid idiot. Do you think that this very platform is a platform of rubbish? Look at Simon Epa answering Murphy. His Facebook is like 20. It's more than 20. So you are still putting a negative picture on your profile, and you are here talking. You are talking to your stupidity. You are just inviting death to your family this year. You think you can come to my platform? This is very. This is a holy platform. We don't talk rubbish here. Any of the admins should do the needful on this idiot. Anumpama. Thank you, Zudo, for this opportunity to spread the gospel in truth and in honesty. We will continue to do so until the enemies are chased away. We will not spare any, both within and without, both eternal and external. We will not spare any mountain. We will push all of them down, not even a hill, no one. Not even a tree. Nothing can confront us and succeed because we are IPOB. You are the everlasting. Continue to guide us and strengthen us and energize us and give us more good brain and the wisdom that in the end you alone be glorified, because Mazinam Kanu must be unconditionally freed and Biafra must be restored, because the enemy must come on their knees in a short time. And Biafra will rejoice in your name, Chi Uku Okike. Abia Mana Prime Henile, we have prayed. He said, thank you, Umo Chineke. Thank you. This very moment we honor you all. From me, the fearless IPOB evangelist Mazi Madab Chimachuku, and from here, our homeland radio in Biafra land, I say good morning to you. Chineke, almost 12. Emete Kwelemi here. I can't say 30 minutes. Oh.